Hi, I'm Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I can't wait to share this video with you today. Yes, that's right. I'm going to share more of the information that I've been learning about style and how to have a better fashion sense and how to look better and more perfectly put together. And in fact, I'm going to be telling you about a wonderful course which is named Perfectly Put Together. And to do that, first I want to introduce you to April Groh, and she is the founder of the Stunning Style Society. And it is basically a complete program in a lot of different ways to help us look and feel our best and help us to put clothing together and just really walk out of the house in the morning with confidence. And let me introduce you to April, and there she is. She is the founder, again, of the Stunning Style Society. And then she says here, if a picture is worth a thousand words, so is your appearance. What are you telling the world? And I think that is such an important part of our lives in terms of our beauty, is our fashion sense. And if we can walk out the door in the morning looking our best. And you know, this reminds me of long ago when I lived on Quinton in Wichita, Kansas, and my neighbor behind me, Mimi Servin, became my best friend. And her mother was named Peg Servin. And you may remember mothers of friends of yours when you were a child. And Peggy was absolutely perfectly put together at all times. She was not only beautiful in terms of her face, but she looked like she never sweat. She was a realtor, and she looked businesslike and professional and really kind of edgy for the 60s and 70s. I guess that's when Peggy was really in her heyday. But I have to say, she passed, which is really sad because she was an amazing woman. Everyone loved Peggy Servin Brown, was her last name by the time she passed. But she was absolutely a charming woman, and everything about her exuded charm and grace and beauty, most especially her clothing. And I remember she always seemed to have the perfect clothing for any occasion. I remember I would go over and be with Mimi on a Friday night, and Peggy and Bill, they were married at the time, Peggy would be going out the door in her tennis togs, I guess, tennis outfit, and she had everything just totally perfect. Her shoes matched her cute little tennis dress. She had the perfect little ruffly panties on, I guess, but she always looked totally perfectly put together. And I have recently been in a fashion phase, and for the last like 3 or 4 months, I've been learning more about fashion, the colors that benefit me, the style silhouette that benefits me, and April Groh and her Stunning Style Society has really been helping me out in this effort. And I took April's free class, which I'll link below, and here it is. It is the free masterclass, 5 Steps to Find the Right Clothing for You. And I learned so much from that class that I reached out to her and asked if she could provide me with access to some of her other learning materials so I could learn to make myself look better and in turn turn you all on to her great classes. And I have been doing that, and I'm going to be making 2 videos about April's offerings. And the first one is on her Perfectly Put Together class. And in that class, I have learned so much that has helped me really look much better than I ever did in the past. Now, before I get into the specifics, let me show you a little bit more about April. And there she is in 3 photographs. And as you can see, she totally does look perfectly put together. And it looks like she's comfortable in her kind of classic but edgy style. And that is one thing that the class Perfectly Put Together does, is the first thing is it helps you find out the things you like and what your perfect style is. And to do that, she gives certain really important tips. And the first one is to take a picture of your outfit of the day, every morning. And you know, I never used to do that. My thinking was, what do you all care about what a girl in Kansas is wearing on any given day? And also, I just felt a little too Instagram-y. I mean, I'm not 19 years old anymore. I just thought it was a little weird to take outfit of the day pics. However, once I started taking the Perfectly Put Together course, I realized that it was a very important way to define your style and to really find out what looks good on you. And so what I did was I cleaned out my closet, and I'll show you my closet in a little while here, but I tried on every single piece of clothing in my closet, and I took photographs of every one. And I really urge you to do that. You might think it sounds crazy, but when you look in the mirror, you see one image. But sometimes it takes actually taking a photograph for you to see yourself objectively. And when you look at those photographs, you're looking first at, does that particular piece of clothing flatter me? Well, before I get into the specifics about the perfectly put together class and how it's benefited me, I will say that it is a series of 12 modules and assorted videos that really teach you everything about fashion. And April actually went from kind of a fashion train wreck years ago. She was a mother of triplets, but really wanted to be fashionable. And so she says that at the time, she really went for every trend possible and wore it all over her body. And even she calls herself a fashion train wreck back then. But now look at her pictures. And as you can see there, everything just looks perfectly put together. She's wearing gorgeous colors. She's wearing gorgeous accessories. Her shoes are great. Her hair is great. Everything about her is literally perfectly put together. And this course is very reasonable in price. It's only $147, and basically it pays fashion dividends for years to come. And one of the first things she has you do is she has you figure out what you like and also what looks good on you. And to figure out what looks good on you, she says, go ahead and take a selfie of every outfit that you wear every single morning. Just a quick selfie, because she says, when you look in the mirror, mirrors lie. And really they do. You can look in the mirror and say, ooh, I look pretty good. But the minute you take a picture of that outfit, all of a sudden you're going, oh my gosh, either that looks really good or what the heck was I thinking? Why was I wearing that? And so I decided to take her up on that, and she actually has a closet cleanout video where she goes through her closet and tells you what she's keeping and what she's pitching. And I decided that my closet was a wreck, which it really was. And so I decided to clean out my closet and to take a picture of every single item in my wardrobe. And I did that. And it took a lot of work. I mean, it was a total wreck. I had a pile of clothes on my bedroom floor, and I put on every single piece and took a picture in the mirror in my living room. And I really was able to hone down my wardrobe into only those pieces that I really liked. Then she says, step two is to say, take every type of clothing you have, like blouses, pants, jeans, shorts, etc., every type of clothing you have, and go ahead and like try on an item and write down what are the things you really like. Like if you've done it with a blouse, what are the things I really like about that blouse? And in my case, I found I really liked high necklines, that I look good in high necklines. I liked blouses that were kind of, you know, nice and slim fitting. I really like that. I didn't like blouses with a lot of ruffles and details. I really like sleeveless blouses. I did not like 3/4 length blouses. I also liked full length sleeve blouses. But basically you write down everything you like about certain items and everything you dislike. And by that process, you're able to learn the things you like and dislike about different clothing items so you can stop making mistakes in purchasing clothing. And in a few minutes, I'll show you my beautifully cleaned out closet. And my closet is one of the greatest joys in my life right now. I have to admit, I'm always telling my husband, you know, I love my closet. And the reason I love it is that it only contains items that I really, really love. And everything is so organized so I can go in the morning and really work from my closet and say, you know, I think I need a gold tone metal belt today. And there is a gold tone metal belt. I think, you know, I think I'd like to wear a black short skirt, and I know exactly where they are because all of my skirts are together, and I'll show you a brief closet tour in just a few minutes. But another thing that I really got out of the Perfectly Put Together Style Masterclass, and I will say I am just skimming the surface of the things I learned, because basically through participating in that class for only $147, my wardrobe has been transformed, and now instead of going to the closet in the morning and wearing the same thing that I wore, you know, 3 days last week because I know it's clean and it looked decent, I am actually getting creative about what I wear and I'm looking a lot better. But one of the things April has you do is create a fashion formula. And here it is. This is the perfectly put together outfit formula. And she says, you know, take your tops and your bottoms, your shoes, accessories, and layers. And she shows you how to use your formula to put together outfits and look your best, walk out the door in 20 minutes time. And she says you shouldn't just have a bunch of one-hit wonders in your closet because, you know, you might have a great blouse, but what do you wear it with? She shows you how to develop a capsule wardrobe so all of your pieces mix and match with each other. And here's an example of taking one outfit and wearing it 4 different ways And it really is amazing. It takes very few pieces, and she's really into that capsule wardrobe idea. It takes very few pieces if you buy the right pieces. If they all kind of mix and match in terms of color and general style, you can really create like 100 combinations out of maybe 25 pieces. And another thing which I absolutely love about April's fashion programs is the stunning style wardrobe guides. And these are amazing. She only puts them out once every season. She has just released the summer wardrobe guide, and I was there for the spring, which was great. But basically what she does is once a season, she opens up the stunning style wardrobe guide just for, I think it's 9 days. It's not a very long period of time. But what she has done is she has shopped classic clothing and she has given you a capsule wardrobe. And in many cases, she urges you to shop from your closet first. And then if you're missing some of the items, you know, she gives you links to retailers that have the various items that she's suggesting in her stunning style capsule wardrobe guide. And not only is it super fun, it helps you really start thinking in terms of creating a whole little capsule wardrobe, not just buying that one hit wonder, but buying clothing that truly works together and makes you look your fashion forward best. Okay, I have links below to April's programs, including the free masterclass, which I advise everyone here take, and the perfectly put together style masterclass, which was what I took, which taught me so much about fashion and wardrobe, and the link is below the video for that. And I thought I would just show you some of my random outfits of the day that I've been wearing recently. It is starting to be summer here. It's not been super hot, but I have been wearing sleeveless, so I'll show you that in just a few minutes. But first, let me show you my newly cleaned out closet. Okay, this is actually my master bath. There's my bedroom in there. And I'll just show you my closet here. And I did this organization before I started watching Perfectly Put Together, but then I used a lot of the techniques that April mentioned in her video to help get me organized. Basically, here things are very organized, and I have labeled all of these different sections. Like this is, what is this? This is shirts, longer shirts, and there they are. And then they're all organized by color from lightest to darker, darker, darkest, and then black. I have shorts there and then short jeans here. You can't really tell, but everything is really rather organized. I have purses up top here and I have costume jewelry there. A lot of different sections here. This is something I may be going on TV, which I'm excited about. So that is something I'm going to have altered and wear that as a top. It's a dress now, but I think it's a little too much, but I might make it into a top. But anyway, there are my sweaters and jeans and that kind of thing. Everything is just super, super organized. And I really took a lot of tips from the Perfectly Put Together video. I have all kinds of shoes over there. They're all labeled. I have shoes back here on the door. And they are all labeled. And one of the tips that April gave was to take the shoes like this and put one going in this way and one coming out this way. They're not all organized like that, but it really does help. I started with most casual on the bottom to my shoe tees, which I wear a lot, on the top. Well, I owe that clean closet to the Perfectly Put Together masterclass because she says fashion is like art. And you really do have to know your palette, to know all the elements that you have, to make sure they all mix and match very beautifully, to make sure they represent your style and are clothes that you really enjoy wearing. And once you do that, you organize your closet, getting together every day is much easier. So let me show you some recent outfits of the day. Okay, this is a dress that I actually featured in one of my Amazon hauls. I really like these dresses and they come in a zillion different colors on Amazon. They're reasonable in price, like maybe $40, something like that, but they wash beautifully. I didn't even have to iron this. I've washed it several times. It is very form-fitting and it looks great on just about any body type. And I've combined it with my gold jewelry, gold statement necklace, which I'm liking those lately. I have a 14 karat gold bracelet, a fakie Rolex gold watch, which was very inexpensive, I'm sure. Had that for quite a while. And then I have my Teddy Blake purse. This is the Eva purse, I think. And I really do like this purse. And it is very neutral. Then I just have on some shoes that I got at DSW, and they're just leather
tan pumps. My husband hates them. They're so clunky and chunky, but that is the style. And I have to admit, I like wearing them on my wood floors much better than the stilettos. Plus, they're just a lot more comfortable. So he's got clunky and chunky. Okay, this is my outfit of the day, and I'm going into work, and this is like my work formula that I wear. It is cold in my work, and I pretty much wear jeans almost every day, except when I have a meeting out of the office, which doesn't happen a lot still with COVID. I try to look okay on the top in case I end up with an impromptu Zoom meeting, because I do have a lot of those. But basically what I have on is just a little halter top. And I got this from Thread Up, and there's always a link below the video so you can get $10 off your first purchase. But I really like this. I think it's an express top, so it's a nice top. It has a little bit of a gathered band here, and it is just black on the back, but I think that looks nice. And then it's got the pattern in the front, a little boho looking. And then I have my Levi's skinny jeans in black on, and I've been wearing these shoes every single day. These are shoe tees, they call them. And I really do like them because, again, they elongate your legs because I don't have a break between my shoe and my jeans. And it just makes your legs look even longer. And it makes me look tall. And for those of you who are curious, I'm only 5'6", so I'm not hugely tall. But my wardrobe formula is basically jeans or dark pants, a shirt, and some high-heeled shoes to go to work in. And someone made the comment in one of my last videos about my outfits. They said, you know, Beth, your outfits are pretty boring. You could really change it up. You could really get to be more stylish and out there in terms of your style. And that is true. You know, if I wanted to be a fashion plate every day, I could spend a lot of money and I could do that, but that does not fit my lifestyle. And so although this looks rather boring to have this formula, it does help me get dressed in the morning, and it's something easy to do. It's inexpensive. And it totally fits my lifestyle. My lifestyle is that Monday through Friday, I go into the office with 9 other women, most of whom are very, very casual, down to sweatshirts and jeans, a lot of them, which I generally don't do that unless it's a Friday. But basically, this is pretty darn glam for my little office of 9 women. I could not glam up any more than I'm doing and feel comfortable there, nor would I want to spend the money on that because I'm really not into that. I'm really a little bit more boho. I know that seems strange, but I'm a little more boho. So anyway, that is just my idea on the outfit formula, which came from the Perfectly Put Together program. This is my outfit of the day, and it is just my typical work formula. I have some dark wash jeans on. These aren't black, and these aren't skinnies. I put the skinnies on, and I look like a sausage. These are just straights, but I really do like them. And then I have some Calvin Klein sandals on that I've had for a long time. Just kind of casual open sandals. Then I have a shirt that I think is a Banana Republic shirt that I got from Thread Up, and I'll put a link below to Thread Up. As those of you who follow my channel know, I purchase a lot of my tops on Thread Up. Jeans and pants, I really prefer to buy those totally brand new. And actually, some of the things on Thread Up are new with tags, and you can specify, I always specify new with tags or appears new because I really don't want any gently used clothes. Okay, this is my outfit of the day, and I'm actually going to a meeting today on site in Winfield, Kansas, which is about 60 miles away from here. And I'm really excited because my son Dylan is now working in my company, because the idea is that in January, in less than a year, he will take over what I'm doing, which is primarily marketing at the company. And so he is coming to the enrollment meeting in Winfield. It's for City of Winfield, which is one of our Flex clients, which is really exciting. But basically, he's going to come and watch me present. And so I'm wearing a dress, which is really amazing. I never do that. So this is just a black dress that I've had for a long time. I think it was Ann Taylor years ago. And then I have a black Michael Kors purse. And I will say it is stuffed to the gills because I have sunglasses in there. I've started wearing sunglasses. I never used to wear them because they gave me horrible divots on my nose, but I found a pair that does not seem to do that. But I do need big purses, and this is just, oh, this is really tiny compared to what I normally need. But anyway, it does work, and it has the silver hardware, which matches the David Yurman jewelry that I have on, which is silver. Okay, this is my outfit of the day, and it is a Saturday, and I'm going over to a friend's house. They're having a little barbecue, which I am so excited that we have passed COVID for the most part. I've had my 2 vaccines, and I'm going to go over there. Most everybody's been vaccinated, and so I'm not going to have to wear a mask. But basically, it is kind of a hot day out and we'll be there from about 5 on. So I've just got some little ankle pants on. I think these are Chico's slimming ankle jeans. And then I just have some little slides on there with the chunky heels. I'm really liking the chunky heels, although Alan does not like them. I think he really likes more the stiletto look, but you know, at 60 plus years old, the stiletto look gets a little more hard to pull off. Plus, I really think that these are in style now, kind of retro to the 60s. And then I have just a little off-the-shoulder top here. I've had this for several years. I got this at ThredUp, of course. I always get my clothes at ThredUp. And there's a $10 discount code below the video if you would like to try ThredUp for the first time. I highly recommend it. So I just have the little off-the-shoulder top, and I've done it with gold accents, kind of my 80s gold statement necklace, I guess. So anyway, I'm really excited to get out there and have a great barbecue with friends in my kind of summery outfit. And my work is very casual. I mean, don't think if I worked in a bank or something, I would be this exposed. But I mostly work with 8 or 9 girls, and many of them, as I mentioned earlier, they wear sweatshirts, t-shirts. I'm really kind of glammed up for work in terms of how most of the other girls dress at the office. If I had a meeting, I would never wear anything like this, but I just like to be comfortable. And in the summer in Kansas, it is super hot. So I really do like to go sleeveless. So this is a nice little sleeveless top. It just ties here. And you know, I really kind of like the boho look. When I was a teenager, and I don't know if you remember this, but back in the 60s, we would make our own shirts. We would go buy 75 cents worth of material and flip it into a little triangle and make a little halter top. And this is the kind of shirt that I would have worn back then. And I really do like it because it just looks very easy and simple. And because it is simple, and this is something I learned from Perfectly Put Together, you can kind of juxtapose things with each other. If you have a very simple top, you can wear kind of a glam earring. And these are some glam kind of drop earrings, which I've just had in the closet. I think these are Chico's slimming ankle jeans. And then I just have some little shooties, but they're a little more bare than what I normally wear because I'm definitely exposing my ankles in this outfit. But I just thought this was a nice outfit to go to work. And after work, I'm going out with Alan to have a drink. Well, that would be iced tea for us. But anyway, I was kind of thinking ahead and thinking I wanted to look a little special when Alan and I go out tonight.
Well, that was a look at some recent outfits of the day. And thank you so much, April, for the Perfectly Put Together Masterclass, because I'm learning so much and it's really helping me feel much more fashion forward and put together. Well, that was a look at some of my recent outfits. And thank you so much, April, for your Perfectly Put Together Masterclass. And if you are interested in stepping up your fashion game, then 1, I hope you'll subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you as part of the 50 Plus Beauty family. And 2, I would love you to check out April Grove's wonderful offerings. Okay, I always like to leave you with a little thought for the day. And this weekend, I have had my Aunt Monique visiting Wichita, and it has been absolutely wonderful. And Aunt Monique is just a wonderful human being. She is loving and kind and just wise beyond her years. I was with her this morning. We all met at my sister's house for coffee, and then we all went out to brunch together, which was really, really fun. And we were just talking, and she said some pretty wise things. And we were talking about confidence. And she said something that was really wise, a way to increase our confidence when we're feeling kind of low. And I know as women that we sometimes get lack of confidence, we don't feel our best, we get intimidated by others, that kind of thing. And I thought Monique's tip to increase one's confidence was so good that I thought I would let her share it with you.
You're going to assume mountain pose. What is mountain pose? Okay, mountain pose is when you put your feet shoulder width apart.
Yes.
So that you are a firm base on the earth.
Yes.
Okay. And then you're going to put your hands on your hips. All right. Already feeling more powerful.
Yes.
And then you're going to stick out your chest. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And then you're going to either open your eyes or you can close your eyes and take a slow, deep breath. And then you're going to put your arms up in the air and you're going to say, I am powerful.
Woo-hoo!
You're going to feel it.
I love that. And you just did it. And does it feel better?
It does.
That is awesome.
I believe it a little bit more that I really am powerful.
Well, thank you, Aunt Monique, for that great tip on how to increase our confidence. I will be trying that out, and I hope you will too. Take care, and I'll see you in my next video.